Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. Today we are celebrating the second day in the season of Advent. The virtue we ask today to Jesus is the strong faith. The gospel passage for our meditation reveals the greatness of true faith. The gospel passage is taken from the Gospel of St. Matthew chapter 8 verses 5 to 11. When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion approached him and appealed to him, saying, "Lord, my servant is laying at home paralyzed, suffering dreadfully. He said to him, 'I will come and cure him.' The centurion said in reply, 'Lord, I am not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I said to one, "Go," and he goes, and to another, "Come here," and he comes, and to my slave, "Do this," and he does it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, "Amen, I say to you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I said to you, many will come from the east and the west and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the banquet in the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. On this beautiful second day of Advent, the Gospel invites us to have firm faith that will withstand all the natural laws and regulations. If we have strong faith, we will do greater things for the glory of God. In the daily running of life, there are important moments where we need to prove our faith. Many things are not clear for us, and we doubt the presence of God, or we feel absence of strong faith to trust in the Lord. Among the Christians, there is a growing hostility to each other due to the absence of sincere faith. Christ is divided because of personal interests and ideologies. There is no more Church of Christ, it's all his or her church. The attitude of Christ is no longer lived by the members of the church. Christ, during his life on earth, welcomed everyone into his life and had the right to come everyone close to him. Jesus expected people to have strong faith in him and a deep trust in him. Jesus looks into the hearts of everyone to know the depth of their faith. Centurion in the gospel is a person of deep faith. He was not a Jew, but he had great respect for Jews and their faith. He had heard about many things about Jesus and had deep faith in him. Centurion had exercised his power and he believed in the power of the spoken words. He had faith in himself, and that motivated him to come close to Jesus to plead for the life of his servant. When Jesus responded positively, saying, "I will come home to heal your servant," Centurion said, "Lord, I'm not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come here,' and he comes, and to my slave, 'Do this,' and he does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, "Amen, I say to you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I say to you, many will come from the east and the west and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the banquet in the kingdom of heaven." How do you exercise your faith? When you are troubled in life with the questions of faith, how do you handle them? We know many things are not within our reach. We need the mighty hands of God to work with us. When we are seriously sick, financially down, relationships are broken, we need our God to stand with us. Today we pray to God for the special grace of strong faith that can remove every hardship from our life. And I pray, may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.